hot water beach. So what do you do when you're at hot water beach?
Dig holes.
You dig a hole.
Keep going, honey. Keep going.
So the idea being, can you sit, there we go. The idea being is that you dig a hole and this water down here that comes out of the hole can get up to 65 degrees C. Woo-ha! So Smithy's going to keep digging a hole. He's got water! Yeah! So he's going to keep digging a hole. We're going to sit in some hot water looking at this amazing sea.
That I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good, so good. I got to you. Everything's changing, doesn't mean it's never been this way before. All you can do is try to know who your friends are as you head off to the war. Pick a star on the dark horizon and follow the light. You'll come when it's over. No need to say goodbye. You'll come back when it's over. No need to say Just because they can't feel it too doesn't mean that you have to forget. Let your memories grow stronger and stronger till they're before your eyes. You'll come back when they call you. No need to say goodbye.
Where are we going, Jess? Where are we going?
You're gonna fall over.
I know. So hurry up. Where are we going? And I'm walking into trees because I'm walking backwards because I'm a moron. It's about a 15-minute hike each way to a cowrie grove. Now, traditionally, all of the English would chop down the cowrie trees before they became kiwis, at least, because they made bloody good material for boats. Now, once a tree is cut down, after a year, it goes rock hard. It's like cement, and we found that out in the Waitangi Treaty Grounds when we was told that as part of a tour. Anyway. I know, I'll break my ankle. Little bit steep down there. Bloody huge spider's web in there. I found a rabbit! Wow, they're beasts! These are cowrie trees. These are about 400-500 years old. And a cowrie can be up to about 5,000 years old. Just to give you an idea of the perspective. I'm a tree hugger. This bad boy's huge. And it hurts.
What is this in our way? Roadhog! It's a roadhog. Hi, Roadhog.
Yeah. They're coming out the gate.
I don't think you meant to come out the gate, though, guys.
Okay, so we decided to make a stop off at the Coromandel Peninsula. This was totally uncalled for. We hadn't considered it in the budget, but we thought it's only about 20 quid. So why not? And we're jumping about on a bouncy castle. It's all fun. We've just had dinner. I've had a glass of wine. My stomach is, oh God, I've fallen off again. Here's my wife.